Welcome back to my virtual over-the-road trucking adventure in Texas. Today we're starting out in Houston, which is where we left off last time. We delivered to this Union Pacific yard down here south of Houston. And then I had to relocate up here to this repair shop, get some maintenance done on the truck. And then, well, I could have just come over here to the dealership, which is where we're at now, so I could rest. And so it's early in the morning. It is 6:15 a.m., and let me finish up with the map here. We are on our way over here to Dow Chemical to pick up our next load. That's where we're going, right there, near the Port of Houston. So, it's 33 miles. Let's go. Hold on, let me see. Yep, I don't need that extra set of tires on the ground, so we'll lift those up. Another one of those now hiring signs. We are hiring, you know, virtually. There's another one. I don't know how he gets those all over here.
Keep right after.
Of course, I'm referring to Trucker King. There's one of our distribution centers, or, oh, it's a store. Retail outlet.
Turn right.
Going in over here somewhere. Oh, right there. Looks like we get a pull through. That's always nice. There we go. Let's get loaded. Oh, I didn't tell you what we're hauling, did I? Explosives. More specifically, dynamite. 34,000 pounds of dynamite. And we're taking this to Junction, Texas. Distance of, well, not actually going to Junction. We're going to this Newport facility this side of Junction. So, but it's 311 miles. So we will we'll just head over there and then I suppose we should head into Junction so we can actually explore it. Following all the rules and laws of the road, we would have had to stop before that railroad crossing because we're carrying hazardous materials. Hazmat.
Go straight.
Are we supposed to do this? Straight, but no. We need to curve up this way. Oh, we're speeding. Shocker. I believe this is Interstate 10. We're going to get on here and take it pretty much all the way to Junction, I think. Let's review that while we're waiting on the light. I-10. Oh, we do get off of I-10 here. It's kind of a shortcut around the north side of San Antonio. Okay. Maybe I should watch the road instead of the airplane. I was just imagining what it might be like here with those overhead roads when a hurricane comes through. I'm sure they're designed to withstand the hurricane force winds, but still, it's got to be uncomfortable being around that. Because Houston is not far from the coast. And it definitely floods here when there's hurricanes and tropical storms. didn't even notice they dropped the speed limit to 55. Must be a construction zone. Okay. Turn my cruise Turn my cruise control back on. Forgetting that it was set at 60 and not 55. I don't like how it grinds the gears when I shift like I normally would in a real truck, and this thing doesn't behave like it would in a real truck. Very frustrating. Exiting here. So this is the bypass around north around San Antonio. Come on, get in your lane. Austin. But we're not trying to discover Austin. So we must be on the outskirts of Austin then. Yep, there's Austin. San Antonio should be to the south. It's hard to see the white lines on this white pavement. Discovering some new roads, and now this is, I thought the right lane was ending up here. Point, eh?
Go straight.
Why don't we check it out? Where is it? There it is. Fredericksburg. Settled by German immigrants. Guys, they're there every day taking pictures. Okay, we've got 26 miles to go to make delivery. Got plenty of fuel. Hey, light. I swear sometimes they seem like they take just as long as they do in real life. And now this one's red. Thank you. Well, I guess we're bringing dynamite out here to this, whatever this is, gravel pit or... something. Trying to get a feel for where we're going so I can get set up. I'll bet we're backing in over here on the left. Yep. Yeah, that's actually hard to see. Oh wow. It didn't look that high from inside the cab. Take a peek. Okay, good thing I looked. Alright, we'll just straighten it up and then back on in. And there we go. So we are a little ways out of Junction. Let's just head on in. There is a truck stop here. I think I'd like to go this way. And then we'll just continue on to this truck stop. And we can consider Junction explored. Oh, excuse me. I've got to go through a cut screen. Look at that load that just appeared magically. I just love Central Texas. I think it's a little hot here, but I think it's beautiful. Of course, I think most places are beautiful, except for certain parts of big cities. Even the Port of Houston, its industry and such. I mean, it's important. Industry is important. But it tends to be dirty and nasty, and I don't like that. We can drive a little faster now. In fact, we can pass this guy. Speed limit's 80, we don't have a load. Let's move it. Except for that. Get up to about 77, and that's where I've got my trigger set. Keep right. for that announcement is, or that warning, slow down. Not a warning, and it's an admonition. Slow down, slow down. I've got that enabled through trucks, but. Welcome to Junction, by the way. I don't know, did we trigger Junction when we drove to that place to make delivery? I guess we must have. Oh, looks like we're going across that bridge. South Llano River.
Go straight.
We need any repairs? Not much. I guess it wouldn't hurt to do that. Woo. Let's see what we got. A little bit of tire wear, tractor and trailer. We'll just get it taken care of. And we'll go down to the truck stop, get some fuel, find a place to park, call it a day. Just like in real life. There's a big lineup of vehicles in the left lane at the light. Everybody must be going up ahead to turn left to get on the freeway and head west. Diane J. Thank you. So it's almost 5 p.m. We started at about 6. That's a full day. We can back in over here next to this guy. I'll just pull up here, get straightened out, and just back in. Let people know we're backing up. We don't have our sleep trigger. What's up with that? Now, I had a sleep trigger when I first backed into this spot. I mean, when I drove through this little spot. Back up some more then. No. That's it. That's all we can do is go. Well, there's a flaw. Okay. Let's pick another spot then. There's a trigger, but I gotta get straightened out inside the lines. Mustn't color outside the lines. Also don't need that third axle group or axle. That'll do it. Okay. Thanks for riding along. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please subscribe and ring the notification bell so you'll get notified for future videos just like this one. And if you'd like to support the channel, you can click the join button, become a member, and have your name on the credits roll, which is coming up now.